Congratulations, you guys, on Between Two Ferns, the movie.
Thank you. Yeah. When, until you said the movie, I was like,
yeah, like this has been a while. It's been a while.
Between Two Ferns, yes. The video.
Speaking of, yeah. When that first video came out a decade ago, the deeply disturbing interview with Michael Cera, how far did you imagine this going?
I thought it went as far as I sent it to Funny or Die, and they were going to upload it one day and then not pay attention to it after that, and no one would watch it, and that would be it. And to have it come this far is just really insane to me. It's not something that we planned. It's not something that I sat there with Zach and said, okay, to really, you know, make sure we break through to the mainstream. You know, it was nothing that we ever thought about. So it's
when
crazy.
Did a Netflix film become a possibility?
We've been talking about doing a film for a few years, and a couple years ago, I just kind of clicked into what the structure of the movie would be. So Zach and I took it to Netflix and barely pitched it, just kind of said, hey, it's going to be filmed like this with these characters, and that's all we know. And, you know, Ted Sarandos said, yeah, okay. And that was it.
The enthusiasm.
Yeah. Worked out.
Lauren, now I believe the film is mostly improvised. Yeah. So what was that experience like for you as an actress?
That was like my ideal scenario. Mm-hmm. I have an improv background. I've been doing improv for like 15 years. So.
And she can't read, so and yeah.
Oh, no. So for me, okay, I just like great. To just say whatever I think of. But it was just so much fun. I mean, we had a great cast of all improvisers. Mm-hmm. Everyone's so talented. So it felt like every scene was really safe to be able to like, play around and do whatever we wanted. And Scott let us get really weird, and that's what we all love to do. So
I would give them one weird take.
Yeah.
And then I would scold them if they did too, say, not so weird.
Sorry. Now, how about for the guests and the interviewees? Like, how much of an idea do they have when they come in of what they'll be hit with?
I usually have a speech that I give to all of them because I have learned in the past that not everyone knows exactly what they're doing there. And sometimes they're told to go there by an agent or a publicist and they have no conception of what they're about to do. So I have a sort of prepared script, and but I still get very nervous before each one because you never know if someone's going to flip out at you. I've been in that situation a few times.
Are you allowed to keep filming if they do?
We usually do keep filming, and you know, it's not comfortable. So I always come in with a lot of trepidation, but at least on the film, everyone was just so generous. You know, Keanu Reeves and Matthew McConaughey and you know, everyone, David Letterman was the nicest, so, but every once in a while someone flips out and it's not pretty.
Now, I'm kind of fascinated by this, like, dual world situation. Like, Zach Galifianakis is a public access TV host and he's interviewing, like, John Hamm, who's just John Hamm. So, Lauren, what would happen if Zach had to interview actress Lauren Lapkus instead of harried but passionate producer?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I guess I would love to see how he would insult me.
Okay, well, just knowing the process, he'd make a lot of Orange is the New Black puns.
Yeah.
And what else have you done?
That's it. So, then we're done. I guess that's probably how it would go.
There'd be a whole section on Holmes and Watson. Yeah. I'm sure. He'd basically just show Holmes and Watson.
Did you just ask him to roast me?
I'm so sorry.
I jumped in.
No one asked.
It's just preparation. So now you know. Now you'll know what
Now I know how it would go. So thanks. I guess I won't do it.
Now, thankfully, no Matthew McConaughey's were harmed in the making of the film. Mm-hmm. But how many ferns do you guys think were harmed?
We had, I will tell you, we had two what we call picture ferns, and we had two stunt ferns.
Stunt ferns.
Yes. Okay. So the stunt ferns were harmed a lot. And I think we went through maybe 10 stunt ferns, and the picture ferns were the nice, pretty ones. So what I really hope people do is they watch the movie constantly looking at the ferns and they say aloud to themselves, stunt ferns, anytime they see the stunt ferns.
Is there a reward if we get it right?
I will personally drive to everyone's house and I'll bring a giant check with me and I'll say, hey, look at this giant check, and then I'll cash it myself and deposit it into my account.
So you can deposit those big checks.
Oh, yeah. You have to go to a giant bank.
A giant bank. Now, assuming this will be a rousing success, because why wouldn't it? What do you hope next for Between Two Ferns? Three Ferns?
I think Between Two Ferns, Between Three Ferns is the sequel's title.
How do you get between three?
That's a good point. I guess
you're each between two.
Okay, each person is between two. Okay,
like Damocles, maybe we split it in
half.
That's good. I'm not sure. But I think a sequel would be really fun to do. We have a lot of ideas for it. So, you know, Netflix, call us up. We're not doing anything for the rest of our lives.
No, Lastly, Lauren, what was like one day on set or one moment or improv scene that sticks out to you most?
Oh, one day that I really thought was great was when we were shooting the scene where we're falling down the hallway with the rushing water behind us, because we had to, I mean, they built like an amazing replica of the hallway that was tilted and then put like a gigantic thing of water that was coming down and knocking us over. And Zach was so funny that day. I mean, he was truly like just an amazing clown. I truly feel like he was like standing up and falling down with the ferns over and over again, and I was just trying to hide my face and not laugh. And it was impossible.
That sounds wonderful. Yeah. I'm glad he was funny that day.
He was. Just that one day.
That one
just
day.
To be clear.
Yeah. Yeah. We tried to shoot the rest of the movie that day because
he was in
we
a
were
good
like,
mood.
He's on fire. But unfortunately.